Hey everyone, and welcome to another Wednesday fan favorite video. And today you guys voted for solving harder trig equations using double angle and compound angle identities. All right, let's get started. So to make this video a bit quicker, I'm assuming you know how to solve basic trig equations like this. Okay, so sine x equals half, cos x equals root 3 on 2, tan x equals 1. So when you have a trig ratio equals a number, they're the basic trig equations. So to save time today, I'm just gonna reduce equations like this to those, right? Because these are the tricky ones that we're gonna have to solve. So I'm assuming you know how to do this. Now, if you want a tutorial on how to solve basic trig equations like this, make sure to comment below. But I'll double the length of the video if I have to go through how to do this. So today we're only focusing on the hard ones. So once I get down to these, I'm done because we can use a calculator to solve for that. So I'm only dealing with how to turn this into that. All right, let's get in the whiteboard. Damn, don't you just love this? Best 5K I spent on this. All right, so first I'm gonna help you, right? So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna look at this flow chart. Wait, what the, I said flow chart, not grocery list. This thing does malfunction sometimes. Actually, that reminds me, I do need the shop, so thank you for reminding me, but let's get rid of that flow chart. Okay, there, that's the flow chart. So let's have a look at this flow chart. So when we're solving trig equations, the aim is to reduce it down to sine, cos, or tan equals a number like I had previously. So what we want to do first is bring everything to one side. So then, once you do that, you gotta ask yourself, can I factorize or use the quadratic formula to reduce it down to sine, cos, or tan equals a number? Because if I can do that, we're done, we can use the calculator. Because most of these, you'll be able to factorize or they turn into a quadratic equation you can solve with the quadratic formula. So, if you can do that, well, you do it and you're done, right? So if you can factorize or use the quadratic formula, do it, because then you've done. You've reduced it down to a basic trig equation. Well, what if you can't? No, well then that means you're gonna need to use an appropriate trig identity, which in this case will be your double angle or compound angle, which is what I'm covering in this video. So once you use your appropriate identity, go back to here. Can you now factorize it? Yes, or do it. No, well then you need another identity to help you. So this flow chart pretty much covers most of the types of harder trig identity equations. There are extra hard ones that require special manipulation techniques, but those questions usually will give you a hand to do those. But for most trig equations, following this flow chart, you'll be able to solve it. All right, so let's look at the first example. All right, so we want to solve this trig equation. 3 cos 2 theta plus sine theta equals 1. So everything to one side, let's do that first. Let's bring everything to one side by subtracting this 1. So now you ask yourself, can I factorize that? Or use quadratic formula? Definitely not, because that looks nothing like a quadratic equation. I've got different trig functions. I can't factorize anything. So that means straight away I need to use an appropriate trig identity. In this case, we have a double angle here. So that means I can sub in a double angle for cos 2 theta. So remember, cos has 3 double angles, which makes this a little triggy. But the aim is to reduce it down to a quadratic so that I can factorize it. So if we remember, I did a video yesterday on cos double angle identities in trig proofs. We can use the same logic here. Which identity will make life easier for us? Well, we're gonna use this one. The one involving just sine theta. Because in order to solve to get a quadratic equation, we need to only have sine thetas. If I only have sine thetas, then that will be a lot easier to factorize and make life easier. So now I've only got sine thetas, and there's no causes left. So now I'll just expand and I'm just gonna bring everything to one to the other side so that this is a positive. So we get 6 sine squared theta minus sine theta minus 2 equals 0. And what you should notice is this looks like this, where x equals sine theta. So now, after applying the appropriate identity, we can factorize it. So if I do it, I'll just do it here in the corner. So this is two-thirds and a half. So sine theta equals two-thirds, or then sine theta equals a half. Now, what I did here was a special technique I have for factorizing non-monic quadratics. So if you want to know the special technique I did to get this pretty quickly, make sure to comment below and I'll do a future tutorial on my Tuesday or Thursday tricks to show you how to factorize it this quickly. But we're done for now, because now I've got sine theta equals two-thirds, sine theta equals a half. I can just use a calculator now to shift sine and get the value of theta. So that is it for this example. So again, you just follow the flow chart. Bring everything to one side. Can you factorize? No. I need to use appropriate identity. Can you factorize now? Well, yeah. Now, no, I did not have to sub it in like that. I could have just written it down like this. Sine theta minus 4 on 6 sine theta minus 3 on 6 equals 0, and then written it down like that. So when you're a more advanced student, you won't need to actually to sub in x equals sine theta. You'll notice you can just factorize it with using sine theta. All right, let's go to the next example. All right, the next example. So solve for x, tan brackets 45 plus x equals 3, tan brackets 45 minus x. Now, if I bring it to one side, to here, we ask ourselves, can I factorize this? Obviously not, because these are not common factors. These are different. These are plus, that's a minus, they're different angles, so I cannot factorize. So I need the appropriate trig identity. Now, this is an obvious one because this is a compound angle identity. We got the sum of two angles, the difference of two angles, so there's only one identity we can use, which is the tan 45 plus tan x over 1 minus tan 45 tan x minus 3. So now I'm assuming you know what the compound angle and double angle identities are. So you wouldn't be watching this video if you didn't know the identities. You're just watching because you're stuck on how to solve these type of equations, or what tricks you need to look for. So then again, we'll put sub the identity in. So now to simplify this, we need exact angles, and you should know tan 45 equals 1. Did make a video, I think it was last week or so, on a trick to remember these exact values using your left hand, but tan 45 is just 1 over 1 minus, yep, just 10x minus 3 brackets 1, yep. Okay. So now we're going to try and factorize this. Now, in order to factorize this, we need to get rid of our fractions. So in equations, in order to get rid of fractions, what we do is we times everything by the lowest common denominator, which would be the product of these two. So essentially, we cross multiply here. So if we do that, what you should notice, if I put this in brackets, that is that times itself. Minus 3, that is times itself. Equals. So now it'd be 0 times each of those, but it's 0 times anything is just 0. Okay, so let me just get rid of the top of the board. And let's continue working up here. So now to expand this, we can use perfect squares. So if you're at this level, you know what a perfect square is. Square the first term. Double their product. Square the last term, minus 3 in brackets, do the same. All I'm going to do now is expand and collect like terms, which I can do in one go. I've got 1 minus 3 times 1, that's minus 2. 2 10x minus 3 times minus 2, that's plus 6, so that's plus 8 10x. 10 squared minus 3 times 10 squared, that's minus 2 tan squared x equals 0. So if I put it in standard form of a quadratic, I bring everything to one side, and we'll get this. Because notice, I can just divide everything by two to simplify it. So then that looks like this. So if I let u equal 10x, that now looks like a quadratic equation. Now, can we factorize that? No, but because we know no numbers times to one to add negative 4, so we gotta go to the quadratic formula. That's why I put that in there. If you can't factorize the quadratic, you go to the formula. So if I do it here, we get u equals 4 plus or minus 4 squared, 16 minus 4 times 1 times 1, which is 4 over 2 times 1. So if we simplify that further, I'll just do it here. So remember, you've got to simplify surge as much as possible. Root 12 will become 2 root 3. And that just becomes 2 plus or minus root 3. So if I just write the final answer, we're using x, so I should use x. 2 plus root 3, 10x equals 2 minus root 3. So then we can just use the calculator to find those values. And that's pretty much the process you want to go through. Just follow that flowchart, write that down in your summary book. All right, so last week's video was on how to make maths notes step by step. That flowchart is fantastic in terms of solving these type of equations. You just gotta make sure you know your identities, your double angle, your compound formulas. Otherwise, solving trig equations is not that hard. Or most of them, right? There are really hard ones, but usually a question will guide you. Otherwise, that's it for this tutorial. Make sure to comment below if you want any of those tutorials that I mentioned, or just comment how much you enjoyed this and that you're gonna use this flowchart. Otherwise, I'll see you tomorrow. Whoa, you made it to the end. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something awesome today. I post 6 videos a week, Monday to Saturday, so make sure to subscribe here, turn those bell notifications on, and watch other awesome videos on my channel right here, okay? Right here. Oh yeah, don't forget to like, comment, and share. Spread the maths love. Can we go to the gym now?